Hello everyone, this is Fontos, and welcome to episode 5 of my Goblin Warlord game. Right now we're looking at my main leader's army underground. It's going to be clearing out some structures this thing and this thing that could threaten some of my cities. But most of the action is actually above ground. I've got 3 full stacks up here. I've got these units. These are all ghouls that I got when Purple surrendered to me. And then these two armies here are going to attack this city as long as Red doesn't have more units hiding over here. And there's nothing overly threatening in here. The priests are kind of scary up on top of that stone wall, but they're still just tier 2 units. I've got stuff that can crush walls, I've got stuff that can shoot over the walls and kill the priests. So that's the plan for next turn, to go get this city, see what I can see inside its borders, once I've got control of it. Otherwise, my cities are starting to make units. This one's just about ready to start making monster hunters. I can make one per turn with a nice bonus there. I've got a settler, I think. No. Yes, I do have a settler. There's my settler. Settler coming down here. Build a city, take advantage of some of these structures here. I'm just expanding really nicely. I'm a little concerned that there's going to be armies coming in from this way, but I'll deal with that when it happens. I've got a lot of unit production going on. I should be fine. Right, I have no casting points. I do have a lot of mana. Let me go through my city, see if there's any that I can make cheerful. Can make that one cheerful. Okay, this one's a little more important. So I'm going to flood around the borders. And again, I'm flooding the borders first just to make it a little harder for enemies to invade. Okay, I've flooded 15 tiles. That should be enough. Yeah, I'm getting 6 happiness per tile. So that should be plenty. Let's move these enemies first. Okay, well, they do have extra units. There's another priest, and that's Rialto the Shocking, the sorcerer that starts with Inflict Stun. So I might rethink that battle. I'll take a look at that at the end of the turn. Got some trouble going on here too. Well, Red cast that Dread Siege spell, but White's threatening to take my city. Not sure this army is strong enough to kill these units with this spell going on. It'll give all units in the city's domain a minus 500 morale penalty. I might be better off, actually, since only the leader is a ranged unit, it might be better if I let them take the city and then go get it back. There is Enchanted Thread, but that won't damage any of my units. Well, all the enemies have finished their turn, so... Okay, I got 120 research bonus. That's a perfect amount. It'll let me get both of these 60 research things. Start with Dispel, just to see what comes up after it. And then I'm going to continue with my plan to get Mounted Archer and then Phalanx. And after that I'll start working on strategic map spells to try to get Embrace Darkness. I might even cast Seek Inspiration instead of Transform Water Node, since there's a good chance I'm going to lose this city. come back to that too. Alright, this city's borders have expanded enough. I still need to get an army up to clear out the ancient ruins and the Sphinx Temple. While that's happening, I can build a war hall and then a guardhouse. I also need a gladiator pit to make phalanxes. So all that will probably take, at least 6 turns. Probably more than that, probably 7 or 8. That'll give me time to get this army up there and clear those structures out. This city's making blight doctors once per turn, so I'm just gonna queue up a bunch. And I'm gonna do the same with monster hunters here. The city made a couple scouts for me. I think I'm gonna make another scout, actually. Send it down to the south. Just make sure there's nothing coming from this direction. I see these floating leaves. What are those from? Are those from the Archdruid? Trying to remember if they're from the Fertile Domain spell that Archdruids cast, or if they're just an animation that happens above forests. Don't have any forests in my land because I converted everything to wetland. I don't see that animation above ground anywhere. If there is a city, I don't know where it would be. Looks like it'd have to be positioned on top of that inn, and that's impossible. So I'm not going to worry too much about that. I'm going to build another scout up here. Scout up to the north. Excuse me. Okay, I'm gonna come sit this army right about here. Ooh. I don't really want to lose this city either. I'll just leave them here. If anything runs in and takes either one of these cities, I can respond. See what it says my chances are. Closely matched. I know Red's already cast a spell. I've got 3 heroes in the battle, plus my leader has all 40 of his casting points. It is an Orc City with Blood Pavilion, though. I think I would lose a lot of my units even if I won this battle. I might be better off retreating, trying to hold on to these cities, at least for a few turns until I can get another army. Actually, if I can push with all 3 of these armies, I'd be able to take that city. So let's fall back this direction so I can sit on top of the trading post. Just deprive them of gold. I also see they've got a big city down here. I bet that's their throne. I was thinking Gargardor would be their throne, but if they have an equally large city down to the south, that's probably the actual one. So if I move south, there's a good chance these armies will run out and try to stop me, and I'll have a better chance in the open field against them. Another good spot for monster hunters. I've got a lot of good spots for monster hunters, but I haven't found any with a a spring of life and a vault of knowledge that would be good for making mounted archers. Goblins don't have great mounted archers, but I'd at least like to have the option to make them. This army's going up to clear out this spring of life and the mine. These guys are still scouting. There's another red unit that I can jump. And I should also pop up there, see what's going on. Guess that's not too far away from Red's land. They could have gotten a scout up there. So I don't need to be worried about Red having cities or anything underground just yet. Gonna let this army heal a little bit more, and looks like I'm adding berserkers to it before I go after these guys. This is another one of those battlefields with a choke point that I can just stack my strongest units in. I actually can't get my butcher up there, but I can block it with the beetle as well. Send this guy around the back just in case I need him. Looks like I'll be able to kill two guys with my leader in one turn. And he got a level up with that. That's nice. Alright, now I'm gonna pull my Warg Rider back just because he doesn't need the experience as much as the Beetle and the Monster Hunter do. Get a critical hit, so now I can finish him off in one hit. Headgear is pretty good. It actually seems like more than an epic set of bonuses. Definitely want to keep that, even though the shield kind of sucks. I'll probably find someone who can use the shield. Give it to the orc. I'd rather have the plus 2 defense on my leader since he already has 100% spirit protection. Oh, let's send it to my Tigran Necromancer. I think he might need the spirit protection more than anybody else. I can get tireless, but I don't have enough upgrade points, so I'm going to spend 4 of my 5 upgrade points so I can get that on my next level up. Let's get Warcry, Shock Protection, and Fire Protection. gonna send this marauder up towards this city, since it's undefended at the moment, just to keep random scouts out of it. And since I'm not transforming a node, I will just do Seek Inspiration. Since the next thing I'm going to research is produce phalanx, it's going to come up no matter what. I'm not going to lose anything with Seek Inspiration. And I'm running out of strategic map spells, so you'd think I'd gotta get Embrace Darkness this time. Gonna see what these white armies do. Well, that's a problem. Some undead stuff found my Monster Hunter city. There's no way I can win this. Even if I try to run away, that dragon can fly and has a ranged attack, so it'd be able to catch me. I'm just gonna try to kill the carrion bird. Bait him into coming after me. Now I've gotta run away so the lost souls don't hit me. Since they wasted that first turn not moving anywhere, now I wonder if I could get away. Nope. Okay, well, I'm not gonna kill anything. I do at least want to damage them. Since they are undead, they won't regenerate health. Only killing one unit, they're not going to gain any levels anyway. Well, got something new for my armies to do. Gonna have to pop up there and find where that thing spawned from, too. Well, White's turn's finished, they didn't attack me. But they did send this Eagle Rider up. Okay, I can make a butcher in one turn. That should be enough to fight off an Eagle Rider, unless it gets ridiculously lucky. I'll also keep sending this guy back. I can get him there at the start of the turn. That might be the quick move that I make. Since I'm not building Tigran cities, I have no reason to get the economic. We'll get the military just in case I end up with a Sun Guard or a Sabertooth Chariot in my army. Also got another research boost. I'm gonna hold off on that until I've cast Seek Inspiration. I didn't see if Rialto the Shocking ran south. Find out though. He couldn't have gotten too far. And that is their throne. Well, the knights are tough, but they've only got two ranged units, and one of them's a warlord. Make sure he doesn't have another weapon. Yeah, he's only got a crossbow. The knights all have thoroughbred mounts and martial arts, though. And He's giving them melee command and defense command. So they'd be tough to kill, but if I could get Red's throne, that would be worth it. Even if I lose some of these units. Okay, let me make all my movements before I cast Seek Inspiration. I maybe should have sent this army after this city. Well, it's too late now. I've got a lot of cities making tier 2 units right now. I can just send a wave of tier 2s after that dragon, and then if I lose one or two of them, who cares? They're just cheap and easy units to make. I'm gonna try to net this guy. Okay, I got him. Even if I had failed, it would have taken away enough of his movement that he couldn't have hurt me too bad. And let's just rush everybody else, take advantage of my martial arts. Nothing except that kobold's gonna hit me. Kobold didn't even try. Do Warg Riders get Warg Riders get first strike at gold rank. That is a really nice thing about Warg Riders. Let's just shoot him. I was considering using the fireworks to try to panic him. Beetle up after the panther. Try to get him another level. Got a level. All right. A bleak warg is a pretty good one. I am getting blight immunity from this blight tusk boar. But if I traded it for the bleak warg, I'd have 60% blight protection, 60% frost protection, instead of 120. I am fighting against a rogue and an archdruid, but not with this army. So I think if I send the boar to somebody who's above ground, if I send it to my elf as a blight weakness, I think that might be better off for my entire army. I could get that watchtower right now, but there's no real reason to. I'll just get it on my way next turn. This army already moved. This one has not. I'm gonna go kill that penguin. Do manual just in case they cast spells. Who wants the last XP? Would be nice to get this mystic leveled up. is still not leading his army, unfortunately. So I might have to give him Inflict Despair. Or maybe Necromancy. Let me see what spells he has. I think he's just got, yeah, Death Ray and Stiffen Limbs. Not the greatest spells you could have. Stiffen Limbs would help against the Warlord. Maybe against the Dwarf unit if he uses Firstborns. But I don't think I need to give him extra casting points. He can do two Stiffen Limbs right now. Plus 10 casting points would only let him do three Stiffen Limbs. I'll just give him Inflict Despair. Despair's a pretty good debuff. It lowers happiness and gives him a spirit weakness. It makes conversions and whatever a little easier. Okay, let me remember to do Seek Inspiration, and of course I still don't get what I wanted. I'm gonna grab Summon Baby Kraken though, since it's free and it is a strategic spell. Excuse me. Oh, I still don't get Embrace Darkness. I'm gonna hit my mana capacity next turn if I don't flood some lands. Let's flood my above ground city. Let's flood this one too before I lose it. I like flooding the forested tiles first if a city has any. Because goblins don't have any bonus in a forest, it just slows them down moving through it. Some other races do get a bonus from it. Some units get forestry. Actually, goblin wargriders get forestry, but other than that, the goblins don't get any bonus from them. Like barons tiles, other races get a bonus from barons, but goblins move through them pretty quickly. Unlike forests, which just slow the goblins down. This army one more berserker before going after that structure. Okay, I need to make units to go get that thing back. Monster hunters are good for that since they'll get a bonus against the carrion bird and the dragon. Let's make a couple berserkers here to use in that battle. And in my throne, there's nothing in particular that I need here. Just go with a Master's Guild. My production's not great. This will let me make like Manticore Riders or Warbreeds or whatever. By that point, I'll probably be able to make them in one turn. I'm just gonna start building up to be able to make cavalry here. Whether that's ultimately Manticore Riders or Big Beetles, I haven't decided, but I'm gonna make one of the two. Just gonna do housing since I might lose this city. don't want to invest any resources there. The amount of gold I get wouldn't be terrible because of the gold mines, but I've got a ton of gold already. I'd rather grow this city up than get an extra 20 gold from it. Halfling unit that was here, I lost track of. It's not going to be able to take any of my cities, though, so I'm going to send these guys above ground. The haste berries are gone. Well, hopefully these don't attack my army. With that sun guard, I might be able to hold off the panther, but I don't think I could handle those air elementals. Let's start sending these after those undead. And get ready to move this guy. White finally did take that. I want to wait till White's turn finishes. Looks like they're already summoning something in there, though. I don't want to just leave the city undefended and let these guys run in and take it. You know what, since I'm not entirely sure I'll be able to retake that city with just this army, I will kill these units and then my other army that's near Red's throne, it can run back and help recapture that city from White. Feels so bright. Can barely see those green snakes on it. Sprint. I'm not gonna do a whole lot with it though. Do I want to give my mystic or my hero the XP? I want to give both of them the XP. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like there's any way to do that. Can't cast Savage Rage on anything. Root Spears would kill him. Give it to the Mystic. Ha. That's a problem. It's also got Dread Siege on it. I do have a lot of armies kind of in the area, so I'm not going to worry too much about those white units. I do need to retreat from this city, though. I'm not just going to throw away that butcher. I'll move those at the beginning of the next turn. Just do auto combat here. All my units have blight resistance. And let's do merchandise since I'm about to lose it. Debating now what I want to do with this full stack. Because I might be better off fighting these guys with my leader's army. I can send these back to help deal with white. I think I'm going to do that actually. First I'm going to clear this. I might lose all those units. Just make a couple different types of units. I'm not sure what I'm gonna need. Okay. Well, those lost souls ran out from this city. Go get them with this army. Just sit back and let them come to me. There's no real reason to rush them. Weaken them. Alright, so now there's just the dragon and the carrion bird in that city. So this army by itself should be strong enough to take care of that. Make a couple more monster hunters. That's a lot of knights. Oh, man. Well, I commented in the last episode that I wasn't sure if the AI would play a human warlord right. Looks like they are. I think I can do this. Not easily. I might lose most of my units, but I can win. Since they don't have ranged units, I'm gonna rush the beetles. Up and hit their walls. Alright, what spell do I want to cast? Slayer's Doubt is nice. I could do a Slayer's Doubt on somebody and a Divine Protection on one of my units. Except none of these enemies do elemental damage, so I don't need resistance. Try Berserk a couple times. I also do have Convert. Knights are tough units to convert, but it's worth a shot. If I can get one, it'll definitely swing the battle in my favor. Try Root Spears. Hopefully they don't get too many more of those critical hits. Now his knights are tough. My beetles and my butcher are just as tough. And there's a critical hit for me. If I do nearly max damage, I can kill him. Got him! Alright. Figure out. Oh, the trebuchet must have shot my beetle with the second shot. And better use my leader to cast a spell. Give lions courage to one of my beetles. Used his unicorn really well here. Turned my beetle around and then ran his knight in to get a flanking hit on me. Okay, let's go for it. I don't think he has anybody who can undo that conversion either. So I think that knight's mine. Accidentally moved my hunter too far there. Okay, let's kill him off. Man. Unicorn's tough. I don't think these knights can kill anything. If they run into any of these three units in the front, they will get killed. Could get a flank hit on my heroes, but only one. And they'd have to run by this butcher all the way. even move the butcher back. Having problems over here, though. Okay, let's give this a shot. I think I need to heal my beetle. Then I'll leave him on guard. Got problems over here no matter what I do. There's a good chance they'll just run up and kill the Storm Sister. That's okay, I think. Because it'll give the rest of my units a chance to respond. Probably gonna lose all of these guys. So if I can get out of this without losing anything, that would be great. Especially if a bell tower hits him. Ouch. Alright, Storm Sister survived. These guys over here did exactly what I wanted. This guy... This guy took two hits from the butcher. Maybe he only took one hit from the butcher. Still, he only took 10 damage from him. Alright, let's just hurt him as bad as I can. That was pretty bad. Please, please, please work. Gonna stay on guard. Hitting him's not gonna do that much good for me. Though actually, if I chew up his movement, might try a berserk with my warlord hero. I think he's probably better off just killing this knight than using a berserk, though. Well, let's get a flank hit first of all. That guy's movement. Is he bleeding? Please be bleeding. Okay, I think I'm better off healing the beetle. course, that knight's got first strike. Oh. I should have looked at that first. Well, I've just got to take the hit. Finish this guy off with a flank hit. Kill the knight with him. Use Iron Heart on him. Start sending this guy around. And let's spread him out a little, actually. Gonna try Berserk. Got him. Now I'm gonna be a coward. Ah, bell tower hit there. Alright, the trebuchet is gone. Hero can't actually get to anybody, but I can get him to run after my knight. Send the goblin and a hero after those other two knights. Get the beetle inside to protect it. Just for fun. Ooh, got it. Alright. Well, with Berserk, that knight's going to... I don't know where he's going to rush, but he's not going to hit anything. Kill him, but he can't do anything. Butcher's gonna win a one-on-one with a knight anytime. Now I can shoot him in the back. Let's see if I have any... Don't have any healing I can do. I'll just get some cheap experience. Actually... Who needs the experience more? They've both leveled up. I'll give it to this guy. Alright, Red's throne is mine. I lost all but my hero in one of my armies. but I did gain a knight. The question now, do I want to plunder this city, or do I want to migrate it to goblins? Or do I actually want to keep it? I could make human knights of my own from it. Let me see what human relations are with me first. They're content. Absorbing would take 5 turns, plundering would take 4, migrating would only take 1. It's already got all the warlord buildings in it, so I probably shouldn't plunder it. I wish I could see how much production it's getting. The dungeon's not been explored. You know what? I'm just going to absorb this. Just because I want to make knights. Get natural immunity since I'm going up against a rogue and an archdruid on the other side of the map. Actually don't know where this light blue is. He's a dwarf. He might have started underground, actually. I think everyone probably leveled up there. Give him first strike. Trying to decide between frost protection to cancel out his weakness or blight protection for the same reason I gave natural immunity to the other hero. I think I'm just going to cancel out his weakness for now. And back underground we go. Another city to meet. Battle seems so anticlimactic now. We just fought a major battle to take out one of the enemy's throne cities, killed a bunch of knights with thoroughbred mounts, and now I get to kill a hatchling. Raptor's kind of tough, but my hero here is a draconian. He's got fire protection. That's gonna help him. Everyone else is on guard. Heal myself. I should have weakened that guy before I shot him. I'll just shoot this guy with my Blight Doctor instead. Now I'll use Weakened to get the experience. Can't weaken him because he's already weakened. Hopefully this thing will give me a Nightshade Fairy, not a unicorn. If I get a unicorn, I'll just have to throw that away. Just have to take the gold. Not a fan of unicorns anyway, but when I am as evil as I am, a dedicated good unit's just not gonna work. Ouch. Well, that's a problem. Okay. I'm just gonna smack the shaman right in the face. Take down all its movement. Then I'm going to go get in everybody else's face. Doesn't look like I can get in that hunter's face, though. If I kill the hunter, I can get in this hunter's face. Okay. Should be enough to save my hero. Now, shoot him in the back a couple times. Let's weaken him first. Yes, Nightshade Fairy. Alright, I don't know what I'm going to do with you, but I'm definitely going to use you. I can maybe use it underground to go fight off whatever white has coming. And this is the army I popped above ground. It looks like it's already in a good spot to join the fight. It's a giant dwelling. Wonder if they're... It doesn't say it's a vassal, so there's probably not giant units defending it. It might be undefended, actually. I could run in and grab it with my scout. Apparently, do these fly or float? Floating. Apparently floating units can move over water faster than they can move over lava. I'm sure that makes sense somehow. Actually, I like this guy having that Helm of Orc Anger. Used it pretty well in that last battle, so I'm going to give this helmet to my other hero, who actually had a spirit weakness. And now he's up to neutral. Okay. think I'm gonna do one more turn. Let's start casting Inspire Loyalty. I have no nodes to convert. Although, Seek Inspiration might be good. Hasn't been good yet. But you never know. I could get lucky finally. Yeah, let's go with Seek Inspiration. I still don't need the gold. That's interesting. It says probable defeat, but with my butcher here, I'm not convinced. Unless they cast some nice spells on me. Hit the eagle 3 times, I will die. Unless I did max damage, I'd actually kill it first. That's probably not going to happen. But then they'd be able to use their spells on my butcher. I think I'm going to sit on defense. I'm not afraid of the eagle attacking the butcher. He can go ahead and do that. Come on. I want to take out this snake before it causes any problems. Advantage of that moment. This turned out to be a nice, easy battle. There's a pretty big white city. I wonder if that could be White's throne. Alright, everyone's turn's finished. Gonna grab the cheapest strategic spell I've got. All right, let's go check the city out. First before Gladiator Pit. I guess it doesn't matter. The city's not going to grow enough to increase my production. Let's do this battle first. forgotten how many of these little battles I needed to do this turn. I probably shouldn't have continued the video. Oh well, it's the weekend. You guys get bonus video. Everybody with martial arts just makes sense to do this. I wish the butcher wouldn't start in the back of my army. It's my toughest frontline troop and my slowest unit, so when it starts in the back, it ends up being useless to me. Need the experience. He could use it. And he got it. It's a couple pretty nice items. I'm gonna keep this sword with my leader. Send this off to someone. It's only a melee hit, so I'll give it to my Tigran Warlord. And I'm going to give the quiver to my Theocrat. Nice to be able to rush a berserker in on them, get my charge bonus. But I'm not sure these guys are gonna let me do that. Here they come. Alright, well, at least got them to let their guard down. That was still pretty easy. Let's make some more plague doctors. These guys can get right up next to the city. Make this even easier. They're gonna half-heartedly rush me there. Gonna weaken him so my monster hunter's shot do blight damage. Did exactly what I was hoping. Turned his back, which lets me get a bunch of flank hits in. Back to making monster hunters with you. Well, I'm gonna have to figure out in the next episode what direction I want that army to run. Looks like there's probably a lot of free land up here, or it could run south and put more pressure on red. Gonna make a barracks. Try to get some of my better goblin racial units, since I'm not really making those in any cities yet. Might as well do that here. Something similar with this one. Okay, what do I want to do with this army? I think I want to clear structures with it. Alright, I feel more confident here. Make a builder's hall. They actually want to flood some more tiles. Let's flood this one too. Let's go after this dungeon. Dungeons give you a reward of units. Hopefully I'll get a couple tier 3s, or a tier 2 and a tier 3 or something that'll help in defending against red. Assassins. I'd like to kill the assassins before they can use their assassin strike, but that's not going to be possible. There's just too many of them. Put Slayer's Doubt on one of them. Let's do as much as I can. perhaps matters. Stupid luck. Oh, I'm just gonna have to take a hit from that one. Actually, since my knight got seduced, he didn't get hit by the assassin. A strange way, seduce benefited me. Tier 3 and a pretty good tier 2. And a bunch of gold on top of it. So I'm gonna keep pushing a little bit. If I'm lucky, I can catch their leader before they migrate their throne. Okay, this is the level. No, I'm way past the level where I want to save to get healing and convert. Divine channeling's probably a good idea. Then I can get Blessing of Health later. Another hostile orc city. That's something I've been forgetting about, is I had this hostile orc city. Now I've got two. That could be something else that I use this army to do. They're not under enemy control yet. That's too bad. I was hoping I'd be able to just run in and grab it. Let this guy scout a little bit. Oh, okay. That's a hostile independent city. So that should be pretty easy to go capture. She already had a quiver. Let's keep that with her and send this to my... Do I want my other Theocrat to have it or my Archdruid? I'll give it to my Archdruid. Alright, I got a Heptatopia bonus. It's the first with 7 towns, that gives me a plus 100 happiness. And now I really do need to finish this episode. It's gone a lot longer than they usually do. That last turn, I didn't think I had any real battles to fight. I ended up fighting 3, I think. Thanks for watching. like, and subscribe. Make sure you catch the rest of the episode in this series and my other series. It seems like I had something else to say. Well, I'll probably, if I remember what it is I wanted to say, I'll just put it in the video description. Thanks again.